next problem. Find the upper and lower sums for the function f of x is equal to minus x square plus 5 on closed interval 0 comma 2. So this is a f of x is equal to minus x square plus 5 is a decreasing function. So definition of decreasing function is for x1 less than or equal to x2 implies if f of x1 is greater than or equal to f of x2, then we call that function as a decreasing function. So the given function satisfies this condition. So for example, take 0 and 2, and clearly 0 is less than or equal to 2. So therefore f of 0 value is 5 and f of 2 value is 1. So therefore f of 0 is greater than or equal to f of 2. That means x1 less than or equal to x2 implies we are getting f of x1 is greater than or equal to f of x2. So for all values, you can check any values in between 0 and 1 such that x1 for x1 less than or equal to x2, we will get f of x1 is greater than or equal to f of x2. So therefore the given function is a decreasing function. So first we have to find the partition for the given interval. So we can divide the given interval in any number of sub intervals, that is our choice. So now we are dividing closed interval 0 comma 2 into 5 sub intervals of width h is equal to b minus a by n. So b value is 2, a value is 0, and n value is 5, because we are dividing the interval into 5 sub intervals. So therefore p is equal to a plus h, a plus 2h, a plus 3h, a plus 4h, and a plus 5h. So by substituting a and h values like this, we will get this partition. So be the partition of 2. Now we are writing sub intervals. I1 is equal to closed interval 0 to 2 by 5, and 2 by 2 4 by 5, and 4 by 2 6 by 5, 6 by 2 8 by 5, and 8 by 5 comma 2. Right. Since f is the decreasing function, for the interval I1, 0 less than or equal to 2 by 5 implies f of 0 value is greater than or equal to f of 2 by 5. So therefore for the interval I1, infimum will be this one, f of 2 by 5, supremum will be f of 0. Reverse out now, values reverse out now, right? In the context, increasing function on up to general ga values vary with angus. I mean, the example solution is decreasing function kabati, infimum supremum change out. So here, infimum value is f of 2 by 5 and supremum value is f of 0. Similarly, for I2, sub interval I2, infimum value is f of 4 by 5, supremum value is f of 2 by 5. And for I3, infimum value is f of 6 by 5 and supremum value is f of 4 by 5. Right. And so on. Now we are writing f comma p, lower Darboux sum. Formula is sigma k is equal to 1 to 5 m of f of closed interval tk minus 1 comma tk. That means infimum of f in this sub interval closed interval tk minus 1 comma tk into tk minus tk minus 1. Right. So by writing k is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we will get these values. First one, for substituting k is equal to 1, we will get I1 sub interval. For I1 sub interval, infimum value is f of 2 by 5. So therefore, we are getting here f of 2 by 5. And this one, t1 minus t0. T1 minus t0 is 2 by 5. Because length of the sub interval is, every length of the sub interval is 2 by 5 only. We are getting the same value. Now, for k is equal to 2, that means for the sub interval I2, infimum value is f of 4 by 5. Right? Next, for I3, infimum value is f of 6 by 5. And for I4, f of 8 by 5. Right? Plus, for I5, f of 2 into 2 by 5. So, here 2 by 5 is common in all these terms. We are by taking 2 by 5 as common, we will get f of 2 by 5 plus f of 4 by 5, f of 6 by 5 plus f of 8 by 5 plus f of 2. So f of 2 by 5 means by substituting x is equal to 2 by 5 in the function f of x is equal to minus x square plus 5, we will get that one. Similarly, f of 4 by 5, f of 6 by 5, f of 8 by 5, f of 2. So by substituting all with these values, we will get this expression. By simplifying this one, we will get lower Darboux sum as 6.48. Next, upper Darboux sum. Upper Darboux sum equal to sigma k is equal to 1 to n m of f of close interval tk minus 1 comma tk into tk minus tk minus 1. So by writing here n is equal to 5, n value is 5, because we have divided close interval 0 comma 2 into 5 sub intervals. Now by writing k is equal to 1, we will get this one. By writing k is equal to 2, this one. K is equal to 3, k is equal to 4, and k is equal to 5. So for all values t1 minus t0, t2 minus t1, t3 minus t2, t4 minus t3, this value is equal to 2 comma 5. These are all length of the subintervals. Now, m of f comma i1 means the supremum of f in the subinterval i1. Supremum. So here, for i1, supremum is f of 0. So f of 0. For i2, f of 2 by 5. For i3, f of 4 by 5. F of 4 by 5. Like this, we will get all this one. So f of 0 plus f of 2 by 5, f of 4 by 5 plus f of 6 by 5 plus f of 8 by 5 into this one. So by saying f of 0 means by substituting x is equal to 0 in f of x, we will get this one, and we will get this one, this one, this one, this one. So you compute this value by taking LCM and multiplying by 2 by 5, you will get this value. Take these two problems as homework. If you not get, I will do. Compute lower Darboux sum and upper Darboux sum for the function f of x is equal to x on 0 comma 1 by taking partition as 0, 1 by 3, 2 by 3 comma 1. So answers are this one. Compute lower and upper Darboux sum for the function, same function f of x is equal to x on close interval 0 comma 1 with respect to the partition, this one. So answer is this one. If you will not get, I will explain all those one. So in the mundu problems ko, ee problems for chinna theda undi. So you can observe this one. The previous problem, f of x is equal to x square is an increasing function. Increasing function means for x1 less than or equal to x2, f of x1 is less than or equal to x2. Kabatti ikkada as is ga, ఈ ఫస్ట్ దేమో ఇన్ఫిమం అవుతుంది, తర్వాత సెకండ్ దేమో సుప్రీమం అవుతుంది, ఎందుకంటే ఇంక్రీజింగ్ ఫంక్షన్ కాబట్టి. ఇక్కడ సో దిస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఈస్ డిక్రీజింగ్, దిస్ ఫంక్షన్ ఈస్ డిక్రీజింగ్ కాబట్టి ఇన్ఫిమం సుప్రీమం రివర్స్ అవుతున్నాయి చూడండి. సో ఫార్ ది ఇంటర్వెల్ i1, ఫార్ ఇన్ఫిమం ఈస్ ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ 2 బై 5, అండ్ సుప్రీమం ఈస్ ఎఫ్ ఆఫ్ 0. సో డిక్రీజింగ్ ఫంక్షన్ అయితే ఇన్ఫిమం సుప్రీమం రివర్స్ అవుతాయి. You have to observe those, that one. So next problem, find the lower Darboux sum and upper Darboux sum for the constant function on close interval a comma b, where a is less than b, right? Now we are taking f of x is equal to k for all x belongs to a, b a constant function, where k is a real number, it is a constant. So every constant function is a bounded function. So boundedness of a function is must for computing lower and upper Darboux function. So boundedness, if the function is bounded, then only we can find lower and upper Darboux sum. Now let p is equal to, we are considering this partition t0, t1, t2, dash dash, tn is equal to b, any partition of ab. ఈ ఫస్ట్ వాల్యూ ఏమో ఏ కి ఈక్వల్ అవుతుంది లాస్ట్ వాల్యూ ఏమో బి కి అవుతుంది అన్ని దాంట్లో మనకు అదే విధంగా ఉంటుంది నౌ రైట్ సో సిన్స్ ద గివెన్ ఫంక్షన్ ఇస్ గివెన్ ఫంక్షన్ ఇస్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఫంక్షన్ కాబట్టి ఇన్ఫిమమ్ సుప్రీమమ్ రెండు కే కి ఈక్వల్ అవుతాయి అన్నమాట ఏం వాల్యూస్ మారాయి కాబట్టి దట్ మీన్స్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఫంక్షన్ సో ఎక్స్ ప్లేస్ లా ఏ వాల్యూ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేసినా మనకి ఇక్కడ అవుట్పుట్ మాత్రం కే వస్తుంది ఇన్పుట్ ఇన్పుట్ ఏ వాల్యూ ఇచ్చినా So by giving input from between a comma b, we will get only k. So therefore, supremum m of f comma closed interval t k minus 1 d k is k. For k is equal to 1 2 3 so on. And similarly, infimum is also equal to k. Infimum is also equal to k. Now lower Darboux sum sigma k is equal to 1 to n m of f comma closed interval t k minus 1 comma t k into t k minus 1. Right. So this value is k. Now we are substituting this one, and t k minus 1. Right. Now we are taking k outside because the summation is for this one, this case. So we are taking k outside. Sigma k is equal to 1 to n t k minus 1, and this value is b minus a. This value is b minus a. Again, similarly, upper Darboux sum sigma k is equal to 1 to n capital M of f comma closed interval t k minus 1 comma t k into t k minus 1. Right. So this value is here also k. So by taking k outside, we will get the summation. The summation value is k, b minus a. The summation value is b minus a. The summation value is b minus a. Right. Here we are getting for this problem. We are getting lower Darboux sum value is k into b minus a, and upper Darboux sum is also k into b minus a. That means we are getting equal values. We are getting equal lower and upper Darboux sum are equal for this constant function. So you can observe that I am explaining this one. K is equal to 1 to n t k minus 1. By substituting k is equal to 1 t1 minus t0, k is equal to 2 t2 minus t1, k is equal to 3 t3 minus t2 plus so on, last tn minus 1 tn minus 2 plus tn minus tn minus 1. So here t1 gets cancelled, t2 gets cancelled, atle t3 value kuda cancel aipothundi. Similarly, tn minus 1, tn minus 1 get cancelled. Tn minus 2 is also gets cancelled from this. So like this, we will get only this value, tn minus t0. So tn value is b, t0 value is a. So therefore, sigma k is equal to 1 to n, tk minus 1 value is b minus a.